Hello dear learners, my name is Priya Bora, Assistant Professor, Department of Tourism, Uttarakhand Open University. So today we will be discussing about Tourism System Models Part 2. Earlier we discussed about LEPA's Tourism Model and DOXI's IRIDEX Index. Today we will be discussing about Butler's Tourism Area Life Cycle and Mill Morrison's Consumer Behavior Model. Starting from Butler's Tourism Area Life Cycle, this model was given by Professor Richard W. Butler in 1980. Butler's Tourism Area Life Cycle model is a linear model with a few assumptions. It displays the various stages of tourism development. It shows the various phases through which a new destination or a new tourism product goes through. Now, Butler recognized six phases in the growth of tourist destination with time. In x-axis, they took time. In the y-axis, they took number of tourists. As you can see in this graph, the various stages are shown in the graph. The first stages is exploration, involvement, leading with development, then consolidation, then stagnation. Then actually it is decided whether the tourism product will either rejuvenate or decline. This model enhances the critical thinking and also can be applied to various contests as it tests the stakeholders' creativity level. It can help us and make us practice tourism in a more sustainable manner, so the resources may be allocated in the very efficient manner. Now, Butler wanted to show that the development of tourism, like many others in life, is not a static process. It is going to change and it will change with the consequent passage of time. Now, changes can be for many reasons. It can be an increase in tourist count, or we can say carrying capacity of that place. It be a change in taste and preferences regarding tourism products by the tourism customers. It can be regarding the marketing and media or the external influences such as natural disasters and terrorism. This model also states that definitely the attractions or the destination is going to pass through these all stages and experience it on their own. Now let us discuss these stages in a more elaborated manner. Exploration stage. This is the very first stage, or we can say the beginning of this area life cycle. In this stage, generally, the tourism tends to be limited in a particular destination. There are very little social and economic benefits in this stage. In this stage, the host community and the government is planning to maximize opportunities for tourists, as the planning phase is this particular phase. The destination is new, so it tends to have very few visitors. Area remains unspoiled due to minimal tourist activity as the destination is a very new developed and it is not well known to the other tourists as well. Now the second stage is involvement stage. This stage marks the development of the tourism process. Development is planned providing various guest houses, hotels, other lodging facilities or restaurants. Foreign investment are attracted and show their interest in various investment regarding things. Infrastructure development, planning is done in terms of providing the transportation or various community-based resources like railway stations, airports, providing healthcare services, etc. Now, locals come in small businesses and provide facilities to the upcoming tourist in that particular destination. Seasonality may seem to occur in this very particular stage. The third stage is development stage. This particular stage involves a lot of planning and development in the particular destination. Infrastructure development now could actually is seen in terms of new roads, new tourist attractions being built, new bus stations being built, or various airports development. The likely increase in the terms of marketing can be seen. Various promotions are being done. the media coverage could be seen for the particular destination in a very high manner. The tourist population may begin to dominate the local population during this period. The area is now acknowledged as the tourist destination. Now the fourth stage is consolidation stage. During this stage, we can see the tourism growth starts to get slow. This might be done on purpose to keep visitor numbers low or to make tourism products and services exclusive, or it could be done unknowingly. In some cases, destination tends to rely upon totally in tourism industry for their source of income. Tensions can be developed in between the locals and the tourist. The discontent level among the host communities may lead to the negative social impacts on the tourism. The fifth stage is stagnation stage. This stage defines the starting of the declining phase. The carrying capacity has become the major issue of the destination as the visitors have reached at their peak level. No longer the destination may seem to attract the tourist and it no longer becomes desirable. This stage slightly tends to show the negative impacts on economic, environmental and social factors of that particular destination. The facilities are becoming outdated, are behind, run down or very poorly maintained. Now the sixth stage is the stage where the either deciding of the product will be rejuvenated or declined. This is the final and last stage of tourism area life cycle, which likely brings out the possibilities for a destination to get revived again or get in a declining phase. The planning and actions of the various stakeholders of tourism industry describes its development project or funding related schemes. Redevelopment could be done in terms of reviving the destination completely. The planning could adapt the sustainable tourism approaches or deciding the target market. New destinations may develop in keeping environment in mind to less disrupt the nature. If changes are not being done, then there are positive chances for the destination may come in declining phases. Now the second model is Mill Morrison's consumer behavior model. It is also known as Mill and Morrison's tourism system model, given in 1985. It is basically a business model where we study the different consumers' behavior, that they are how they are acting in a particular destination and how they are buying the products related to tourism. This also mentions the various stages that an individual goes through while buying any kind of tourism products. In this model, we have different kinds of elements that you can see in the following figure. We have here four elements. All are interlinked with each other. Also, this is a cyclic model. You can see market and travel are linked by the travel purchase. Travel and destination is linked by the shape of travel demand. Destination and marketing is linked by the selling of travel. And finally, the marketing and market is linked by reaching the marketplace. As you can see, the model is somewhat kind of similar to Lipper's model, but the presentation tends to be different. This is the cyclic model and one component is leading us to another component. Let us study about the each component one by one. Market/demand. This consists of the tourist region from where the certain demand arises. The demand arises from the tourist, the desire to travel which satisfied their need. Certain motivation and perception regarding the travel could emphasize the travel. The internal and external factors are responsible for their traveling. The second component is travel component. Now here the different segments of travel destination is being evaluated by the tourist, like traveling for business, meetings or relaxation, recreation, leisure, pleasure, etc. Where to travel, how to travel, when to travel, how to reach a particular destination, who to travel with, are the certain questions are considered by the customers. The modes of traveling are also considered under this, as this links up to the destination, which means how are we going to travel and reach that particular place. The third component is destination component. This acts as the main region where tourist tends to travel. This can act as TDR region of Lippe's model and also acting as the pull region. The area attracts the tourist and shape the seasonal tourism demand. Like demand for hotel or demand for any particular destination, the standards and policies are made accordingly. Here, destination management will undergo the planning of the destination, will undergo research that how to manage the different tourist and activities conducted at a destination. The fourth, the last component is marketing component. Now, the various suppliers from the destination, like all the hoteliers, travel agents, tour operators, will bring out their products and will place and price them in the respective markets. They will promote it via various ways of advertising. This may influence the market, and the tourist can know about the tourism products available in the market. Now, for example, we can take of the promotion of certain destination of Uttarakhand has been done so well through the channels of advertising, and by seeing that advertisement and getting information about the destination, people will realize the need to travel and will get motivated or be triggered to visit that particular destination. Thank you. That's all for the day.